Hi Vijay.
Hello Aditya.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
In fact, a lot of people have been asking us that, you know, where is Vijay? And
actually, you also asked me that, and sometimes I did not believe you, but actually people, when they came to me and they said, we are actually waiting for the next part of the speech correction thing. And it's really been long. I've taken a lot of time between two sessions.
That's no problem, but what you captured in part one was very good help to a lot of people, and the perception towards pitch correction of, you know, musicians and engineers changed.
Right.
Your information.
Actually, what you're saying is right. Also, what I realized that people had their opinions about pitch correction. Means ethical, this thing also, not only technical, but ethical, that why should you do the pitch correction? Why can't the singer sing in pitch? So that's why actually we had given some small technical explanation that why we need it now.
Yeah.
Because now, since we are moving from the live 50 musicians session from one music producer and couple of musicians, so how the spectrum of the pitch or the bandwidth of that particular frequency has narrowed down, in which the singer has to sing, and that is why a little bit of pitch variation also sounds as basura. So that there were some arguments on that explanation also. And also few people said that there are few errors that they failed, but it's, here is the technical explanation to that thing, that one guy said that you said half semitone, whereas the semitone itself half of one tone, one note. But I have the explanation. What I had said, that how the autotune works is, autotune or any pitch corrector for that matter takes the frequency in consideration. So C note and C sharp note is semitone. So why I said half semitone, because autotune considers this C. So 50 cents before the C note and 50 cents after the C note as C. So any note standing between that frequency range, which will be considered as C. And beyond that 50 cents of C towards the C sharp will be considered as C sharp. That's why I split that semitone also into half. And that is why I was calling it half semitone. So that is the area of one particular note for the autotune. And that was the technical explanation to it. Also, some queries were there. As I had said, that we can use all these tools as creative tools also. So someone said that, is it possible that we can use these plugins like the harmonizer, vocal harmonizer? So yes, definitely we can do that, especially on the Melodyne, where you can create n number of harmonies with the one single vocal file. So we will come back to Melodyne and harmonizing the vocals later, but yeah, definitely we can do that. And also there were some queries which we will, when we will do the demo of Antares AutoTune, we will clear those doubts and we will explain some tricks how to use that. So here we go on the second episode. We are going through two basic types of pitch correction softwares. One is a real-time and one is non-real-time or offline, we can call it, because autotune is something which analyzes your audio every single time it passes through that. So every time you play your DAW, autotune analyzes that audio and corrects it every single time. So every time you change the parameters, it will perform differently and it will correct it according to those parameters. Whereas some plugins like Melodyne, they are you can call it non-real time or you can call it offline, because what it does is it actually takes that audio within that plugin. So it digitizes that audio and processes that. After that, whichever signal going through that, basically any signal passes through that, it completely ignores that and plays back the same signal which has been recorded earlier and which is processed earlier. So we are talking about AutoTune today specifically, for the simple reason that it's it has become an industry standard world over. So we are just checking few features, not few, actually we are checking all the features of AutoTune. Although you can check all these features on the website of AutoTune also, but what I am going to tell you here is how that feature is used and some tricks to use it in Pro Tools or in your day-to-day recording life. So here we go. So here we have Antares AutoTune 8 here. The window is open here on our screen. I'm quickly gonna run through all the features given on the AutoTune window. We start from the input type. So the signal which is being fed to the plugin is whether it is the voice range ranging from soprano to the low male vocals. Then there is instrument and there is bass instrument, so that actually the plugin analyzes accordingly the kind of input given, input signal given to it. It selects that particular range of the frequency so that it can precisely correct the pitch. So here we have soprano, where which is a very shrill and high female voice. Then there is alto and tenor, which is like mid octave pitched voice, and the low male voice, like real baritone voice. Then there are instruments. Why that instrument category is separate? Because while we try to pitch correct the instruments, there are heavy harmonics involved in that signal. So that's not as smooth signal as the voice signals are, and that is why there is different algorithm given, which is instrument. And also the bass instrument, as I said, that selects that particular range to correct. So these are the input types. Then there is a knob known as tracking. So basically, if you have some noisy signal in your vocal track, or whichever signal you are trying to correct, is if you have a noisy signal, some headphone leakages are there, then what you can do is you can move this tracking knob to choosy. So it becomes a little choosier and it takes only the audio signals to pitch correct and ignores the other things. As you go relaxed, then it takes everything, it takes all the signal into consideration to pitch correct. But then sometimes what happens that because of the noise of the surrounding this thing, the main signal has some surrounding noise that takes that noise also into the consideration, and it does not do the pitching precisely. So you should put it to relaxed only when your signal is very clean, or you should keep it default. When on the AutoTune, on any knob, when you double click, it comes back to its default position. So you can keep it on 50, which is its default, and do your voice pitching or whatever that signal pitching is. Then we have the select pitch reference. You can see this is grayed out because this is on a mono track. This is simply there because it asks you that it's a stereo track and which signal I should consider as the pitch reference and correct both. So you can select left or right, whichever your signal you think is good as reference, and you can feed that signal. In case of mono, that grades out because there is mono signal going in. Now there is low latency monitoring. Now this feature is new in Antares AutoTune 8, where what happens sometimes your artist insists that I need to record my vocal along with the pitch corrector inserted into the track. So in that case, what happens, for any pitch corrector, it takes its own time to take the signal, process it, and then play it back to you. So that milliseconds delay also can bother you when you are singing with a track. So that feature is there where there is low latency playback happening. In that case, you can insert this into your track and record that real time. Now, one small trick is there. When we say that insert a plugin into a track, in Pro Tools, if you are using native plugins, what happens is while you record any audio track, it disables the plugin because it's native plugin. So what you will do then, if your artist insists that he or she wants to track the vocal along with the autotune inserted on that, so there is one small trick. As I told you, if you open a plugin here, if you open an autotune on this audio track, you label it Vox 1, set the input, record enable, and the plugin is gone. It's not working anymore. So there is a small little trick on that. You should open one auxiliary track. Open an auxiliary track, give the input as interface 1. So your microphone signal is coming in to the auxiliary track. So this is your mic in. Now set any of the buses. Unfortunately, we don't have any bus assigned to this. So what we will do is create a new track. Create a mono audio track, label it as AutoTune Vox. Drag this plugin onto your onto your input track. Now just understand the chain. The microphone's input, the signal is coming into the auxiliary track, and the auxiliary track is feeding the same signal to the audio track, which is record enabled now. Now your plugin is active. Do your settings on this, and it starts recording whatever information is coming in to the plugin that is getting recorded here. Now sometimes artists can ask you that I want the autotune inserted, but I don't want that to record the information. I want the autotune to act post my recording, but still I want to hear through the pitch corrector only. So in that case, what you will do, it will be exactly the other way. So what we will do is the signal will get recorded onto your audio track. So the interface input 1 that goes out to the AT Vox, and there's here it goes out of the interface. Now you record your signal on the audio track that passes through the auxiliary track, which is going out, and through the interface out, the artist listens to it back, so that the information getting recorded is the pure information which is not processed through the autotune, whereas the playback, what the artist is hearing back, is a processed signal through the autotune, which is routing through an auxiliary track. That's a small little trick about it. So moving on to the next feature here, which is the selection of key. Whichever key your song into, you should select that key, and there are scales, different scales given. You choose that scale and it will target all those notes which are involved in that particular scale only. So we have some samples here, so which is in scale D. So we will select the D scale, and here are these scales, different scales given. There are some equitempered scales also given, whereas there are some Eastern scales, Asian scales, some Chinese scales, Indian scales, which has got so many notes involved in it. In Indian classical recording especially, we talk about, sometimes artists say that no, I'm singing classical, so I really don't want any pitch correction happening on that because it is equitempered, and we don't consider the equitempered tuning as the natural tuning, and we have so many shrutis involved in some ragas which your equitempered scale will spoil the feel completely. There is so much to learn. It's the very deep topic, so we will just quickly bypass that and move ahead. In Indian scale, there are 24 notes involved. So all those different scales are given here. So if you have a song which is in major, you can simply select major. Your scale is in minor, you can simply select minor. But the smart thing is to use this thing as chromatic and use your scale from here, for a simple reason that if you have some accidental notes happening in your song, then you will be locked with your major scale here and you will not be able to add any more notes there. Whereas if you keep it on chromatic and select your major or minor from here, you can simply remove and add some notes here and bypass some notes here, only in case of you are selecting it in this intersection and not here. So we will come back to this later. Here you have this scale detune. If there is a track which is already recorded, and ultimately while singing you understand that this track is not 100% in pitch. So what exactly does that mean is, it's not in reference with 440 hertz as A note, but there is some offset has happened. So in that case, what you can do is, you can simply put that offset in here by hearing, or if you know the exact amount of it, you can select it either in cents or in hertz, or you can hear it and you can tweak it and bring it to the scale also. As I will show you here, I have one tone here. Quickly tell you, this is the meter which shows you how out that particular input signal is. So what it says that it is a B note, but it shows that it is flatter by around 25 cents. So why we have taken this particular signal, just to know that how does this scale detune acts. So ideally what you can do is, you can offset that. This is actually your proper signal, which is like good sharp by some 6 cents here, 23 cents and 6 hertz. So you can set that off to the scale detune from here, offset that particular input signal and match it to the track, so that the vocals and or whatever that input signal is, that and the track is in pitch sync. The next thing here is the transpose. Again, the same thing, as this is in the fine sense. Similarly, if your track is in B flat and your vocal is in A, what you can do is just move it by one note. So it's transposed to one note and it has gone up by one note. Here you have the throat length. The throat length is a formant. What happens when you change the pitch of any signal, especially the vocal, what happens that if you push it too high, that sounds like a chipmunk, or if you push it too low, then it sounds like the unnatural bassy voice. So what you can do is, it actually changes the throat length. What happens if a small kid singing A note and an adult singing an A note is a different texture and timbre completely. So what you can do is, you can match it with this. I will pull out one voice sample and I will show it to you later on this. The next thing is correction mode. As I said, there are two different modes on AutoTune to correct the pitch. One is graphical mode and one is auto mode. Graphical mode is an intense topic again, which we probably will take one full episode on this, but we will just leave this for right now. I will explain you the entire window of the graphical correction. Right now we are talking about the auto pitch correction, which is this page. Now there is one small key which says option. In case of option, what you can do is, you can set your buffer. This buffer you can set for your graphical correction, because when you use the graphical correction, it takes all that information into the buffer and processes that, so that you can correct it and it plays back and you re-record it on some other track. Till then, that information stays inside the plugin, and that is why it takes some space, and that is why that buffer is there. You have to select that buffer. Most of the times, a good song is good enough with 3000 buffer size. That's actually in the millisecond calculation. So max it goes to 10,800. 3000 is good enough for a regular length song. Second thing is the number of undos you need on your AutoTune while you are doing the graphic correction. Then there are so many other features which one by one we will go when we actually work on the graphical correction mode. Then there are the auto scroll modes. So you have your knobs on your software, on your plugin rather. So how do you want them to act? Like if you drag them and push it up, it goes up, and drag them down and it goes down, or you want it rotary, you have that options at preference to select, and you can keep it as your DAW defaults also, so that that follows your DAW defaults. Then it has the auto update option also, where it automatically keeps checking that if there are any updates of the software available. Here we come. That's the option. I'm sorry. That's the option of the knob, where if you want it to the linear or circular or the follow host. Then there is this entire section is for your graphical pitch correction. So that there is a window here where there are tools. So you can simply select these tools with your mouse also, but you can assign them to your function keys also, which is here. So that's about these options here. Coming back to the auto correction mode again. Now we move on to the pitch correction control.